ISSS 2016 talk preview. Okay, so one of this year's theme is about unity in diversity. So where should we start? Let's start where I met John Kinnaman and Judith Rosen in Sick What Is Life. I gave a talk about chicken or egg, which one come first? And then I said, okay, it's the observer come first. The observer put the boundary between the chicken and egg cycle, and then so observer came first. But without the system, where's the observer? There's nothing to observe. So there's a boundary between the chicken and egg system and the observer. So do they exist together at the same time? So our conclusion was, as it is. So today, where do we start? So today we start with a set theory. Set theory will say, okay, here's a set. What outside set is not A. The relationship between two things is the A union not A, which is everything, and A intersect not A, which is nothing. So here we've got these four things. It's actually from India about the Tetralama. So then people try to form this a set theory, but then get into paradox. But maybe the problem is, what is not A? Not A maybe not be a set. It's an environment. And then what's everything? Everything is not a set. It's A union not A. That's all you can do. And what is nothing? Nothing is A intersect not A, not A. That's all it is. But empty is not actually a set. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe not. So in today's set theory, we've got a special universal set. Within that, everything will be confined, will be good. So everything will be happening within the set. I call it as space. And then there will be A and not A in the set with S. So how about with Chinese medicine? Did you use something similar as this differentiation and set theory? Yes, we have got lots of different differential diagnostic process, but all of them have got the same common structure of a 3D spectrum, which is like A and not A, and then the change between them, we have got the excess and deficient spectrum. So with the same trick again within the A, then we have got the yin and yang, and change between this boundary, we have got the hot and the cold spectrum. And this same thing is like a system within a system, and then it's like the boundary becomes the another component, which we call the superficial, which is like the interface between the internal, external, external. And the balance between them will also be the another spectrum. The 3D representation is like this. Always try to keep you within the sphere to be healthy. And then that this is the 2D representation, which is the good and evil yin-yang chart. Okay, let's start from another point of view, diversity. Okay, the physics. Okay, with most famous formula, E equals MC squared, can we rearrange that and becomes this? And then what is this? This part is the yin, this part is the yang. And then in between is the Tai Chi, the operator that's separating them. And here the operator is equal. And then we have got, could have a greater than or smaller than, of course. And this go back a little bit to be the most important equation in system theory. It's talking about 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So the system thinking, system scientists will say 1 plus 1, there's 3 things in there. And then the reductionist will say, no, it's only 2. So it's actually two sides of the equation. Here, the same thing again, the yin and the yang and the Tai Chi. So you have to look at that at the same time. It's different application, will stress on different component. Is that the answer? I'll let you think about it. Okay, we go back to the physics, and then on this side, deficient in geometry, it means compression. And multiplication in geometry, it means expansion. So how do you do expansion? In order to go from matter into energy, you need something to initiate them, which is the neutron, which is what happened in the nuclear plant. And in the other one, how do you compress energy to become matter? You need a compressor, a collider. That's what the CERN is doing. You give lots of energy and then you compress and let them collide, and then you got new substance. So here it seems that with the yin and yang, you need two more things. to actually make the whole cycle going, which is the initiation and the compression. And here we have got this, the five components, the five element system. So this is how we come from differentiation into the three things, Tai Chi, Yin Yang, and then five things, five components. Okay, so let's go another point of view, diversity. Our theory. Okay, in our theory, relational theory, which is derived from the anticipatory system by the Rosen family. So here we have got in the workshop in 2013 by John Kinnaman and Judith Rosen, we have got this. And then we conclude and find that, whoa, five elements with similar property. Interesting. Okay, another point of view. In the IEEE S2014, the DSRP system thinking. And then after extensive study, the author said that we have got the point view, we have got the perspectives, action and reaction, and then the system and part, and this is everything. And then with that, the changes in this ball, the relationship between them, we can form lots of different models for analysis with different problems. And then, can I rearrange that? And the fifth one, what's that? That's the meta-analysis. Again, similar same components, similar properties. Of course, need more research. Okay, let's have looked at five system model again. Okay, we've got five things, and then we've got relationship with each one of them, forming the birth cycle and the control cycle. Okay, here, we can do the same thing. Everyone is a system. We can do the same trick again, make it into three, and then five. And then that's what Buddha do. In the teaching of Buddha, the five aggregate is how we use to describe the property of the human, and then in the middle is the physical system, which he can actually again divide into the four elements, and then maybe the fifth in the middle, emptiness or void. And then here we have got the five elements, and we have got the three and five, and keep on doing that. What does it mean? The same rule apply again and again in all the levels. In mathematics, it's called fractal. So this one is like what John Kinnaman actually did the talk on ISSS 2013 about. His research showed that from our theory, the whole universe is a fractal universe. In the ISSS 2014, the system engineering SIG, and then I've got the traditional Chinese medicine engineering. Okay, things can get really complicated, and then even if we analyze using system thinking, it could be something like this, as found out in system dynamics. So in practice, in Chinese medicine, we only have three levels. We don't go up to so many levels. So what we have got is like in Confucianism, we have got the heaven, the earth, and the human. It's like the human is the system I, J, K, but then we go up one level, which is I plus one, and go down one level, and that's what we use to understand. And then with the help of the teaching of Buddha, we say that, okay, with the middle, if it is the system, level I is five systems, in the teaching of Buddha, okay, you divide the middle one, the earth system, into another five. So can I divide another here, which is the water system, which is another more important system as described in Lao Zhi, the Dou Tak Jing, talk about the water is the most important one. If we divide that, what have we got? We've got this 13 level. And I got this. Have a look. This is the model that by Ken Palmer, he did the IEEE workshop on 2014, and then have got this. The environment is the meta system, different properties, the system, different properties, their special system in between, different property. Whoa. Okay, and then we go back to mathematics. And then in geometry, so we can draw all this special die shapes of equal length. Each one of them, and in 1D, 2D, 3D, 4D, 5D, 6D, they are restricted many. What happened in 4D? There's a special one. It's called the hypertetrahedron. What the structure is like? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tetrahedron. And then joined together, each one of them is connected to the other one. Does it look familiar? Okay, we can also apply that to the viable system model. Uh-huh. That's what I'm doing with Lewis Kang. Uh-huh. We do this, also did a paper on the yin and yang of change, and then got published in the leadership of the classics by Springer. And then this is what we are working on, a little bit blur, it will be clear when we publish our paper. So here we have got everything together, a coincidence, or the truth. Should we go for diversity or unity? The last example, with Chinese writing, we write it this way. In English, Western writing, we write it this way. Okay, we use this to represent our ideas, emotions, systems, instructions, and knowledge. Five things. Okay, so when the East meet the West, what will happen? Okay, here. Could this be the one? Will that be the harmony and peace? I would say, with system thinking for system scientists, we are still at the dark age. But no worries, it's only in those dark, lonely nights can you see the light within you that is shining bright. Keep on doing what you believe is right. Only if that could bring you and others peace and harmony and the wisdom light. I believe. Do you? I'll meet you there. If not earlier, somewhere along the path. Thank you.